Okay, let's make an island ocean bar table. Hello everyone, and how you all doing? Yeah, so Rock's Original back again with another one. We're doing a ocean bar table. So just laying out the sand, and I've got all my stuff ready, all my materials, pebbles, moss, little stones and gravel, shells, little leaves, fake plants, and of course some fish. So I'm just, I've already done this once and didn't like it, so I removed it all and started again. And so here I am now, just going with this look, just sorting out the pebbles, getting everything into place, putting the little flowers and fake plants underneath the pebbles, just to keep them in place for when I pour the epoxy. And yeah, notice that I haven't poured any epoxy yet. Normally, like, you'd pour a base pour first and then let it set, or you'd pour the pour and then set the cookie on top, but you don't always have to do that. So I've gone with the dry look because I'm in a silicone mold, so I'm gonna pour everything afterwards. So we're nearly coming to sort of the end there. These yellow flowers was a mistake. I actually got rid of them, as you'll see in a minute. I do like the little long stem ones, the greenery that I'm putting in. It's always good just to have a little try and a mess about. First of all, try a few different things. If you're not sure on it, take it out and try something different. Like these little long grass ones, they go well. And then just highlighting a few areas with the black Roman gravel. Stones, almost like white. They look like shampoo conditioner, that kind of it's almost like a pigment. So I've got some little fish, I've got a couple of whales, and I've got a shark, and I'm gonna just drench the sand first off in the clear epoxy, and then I'm gonna go around the outside with this blue and white pigment mix afterwards. So just go around it, get everything sort of drenched, get like the live moss, which I haven't put in yet, but you normally, I should have put it in there, but I don't, I do that as an afterthought. So once you've got your blue in, you can start putting your little waves and your shore foam, your shoreline foam in, like wave effects. I do different kind of waves. Don't do it with the heat gun like you see most people do, and they pour the clear on it. So I've done it this way. I think it come out alright, it looks nice. Yeah, I'm happy with that. I'll start putting the fish in now. I was just going to go with a couple of sharks, and then I thought, no, I'll put the whale in as the protectors. You notice like the little ones be swimming beside the whale. There's a predator there again for the two little ones. He's got his mouth open, he's very hungry. So they're sort of like swimming around the island. That's what I went with anyway, that's what I was trying to get, that sort of effect. Only a cheap project. I mean, these cookies, you can pick them up. These are cedar cookies. There's not much to them really. They ain't got no amazing grain or anything like that. But I do change it up at the end. They do get a nice look to them though when the epoxy gets on them. They do pop, I'll give them that. But there's just not much to it. They're just very there's not a lot of, not of no figuring in it or nothing like that. So I mean, the UV resin there, it's going over the moss. This is dried moss, it's not reindeer moss. I thought, it's like stagnant moss, but dry. And UV torch. That's very convenient, yeah, UV resin, when you're doing little things like this. So there's another 750ml all clear. And then I mix the other half up with blue. There's the blue part. Be careful when using the blowtorch also, when you've got plastic flowers in there. So this is 900 milligrams of blue. This is the blue tint. I think this is the part where I've got quite a few micro bubbles. It does affect the end look of it, not a great deal, but not them bubbles, but like micro bubbles. So I'm just going in with a drill bit, a bit of isopropanol, just to keep the dust from going everywhere. You can just use water, but alcohol dries quicker, so that's why I use it. So once I've got them out, I actually fill them first. Just get the epoxy in them, so when you do pour your main pour, you're not going to get no trapped air, because you can pour the epoxy over it and you trap the air in, like what you've dug out, the epoxy sometimes doesn't go over it, so I always make sure that I go in with the point. You can use a cocktail stick or any kind of little thing like that, just to make sure you get it in the actual hole that you've dug out. So more blue resin, that's another 750 or maybe 800 mil there. I'm blowtorching it now because I'm over the threshold nearly. And now this is the last bit. This actually gets it up to the rim, and I can start to get this ratted out. Wrap it down as much as you can near the rim, and then what I do, I go in with a grinder using a 40 disc, a 40 grit flat disc. So just hog out the majority of it. And I'm actually going to go and do this outside, so I don't want to make too much dust. There's enough dust in that shed as it is. So got it nice and flat now. Just gone over that with a 40, and now I'm going to use an orbital sander just to get rid of the grinder marks, just to get it nice and uniformed. I just left it in the mold, because the mold acted as like a nice rubber mat, so that don't move. So as you can see, there's no resin on the actual part of that cookie. That's not a problem, but we'll deal with that. So I'm just putting my little stamp on it. This is the underneath, obviously. Quick sand. And she's good to go. So I'm just getting rid of all the little bits on it. Just getting it smooth, ready for the first seal coat. Now notice here, I'm using the proper discs now. That little 125mm disc I was using before, they're cheap. These ones are a lot better, and you can see the difference and how quick that it deals with it. These are actually for epoxy. These discs I get, they're from Germany, same place I buy my resin from. Company called Rasafit, and they're based in Germany. I've been dealing with them for about 3 years now. That's the only resin I use. They've got all types. They've got a tabletop, deep cast. They've got even pouring for pool, like a swimming pool or aquatic. So Yeah, got a wide range of accessories as well if you want to look up on their website, VasaFit Epoxy. And they're cheap and all, works out, you get about £8-9 a kilo. Yeah, so you get like 15 kilos, cost €127. So yeah, it's quite good value for money. I wouldn't use, and that's for tabletop epoxy. Casting epoxy is a bit more expensive. But if you know what you're doing, you can get away with using tabletop epoxy, especially when you're doing a pour in different stages. Because if you're using loads of flowers and plants and rocks and sand, it will push out air. So it's best to get it locked in, sealed, like you see me do at the beginning. Just going over it and drenching it and then letting it cure up for a day. But try and catch it at the B stage when you pour, when it's still tacky. And that way you get a proper mechanical bond, much better than when you scuff it up. But if it does have to cure up properly, then you will have to sand and scuff it up, which I'm sure most of you will know by now. You watch the resin videos from making tables. A lot of bubbles there in that resin, but this is only the underside, so I didn't really pay much attention. You almost see it looks like very, very cloudy. So just put a little bit on, just let the wood sup it up. Like that, and then bosh, just push it up and the epoxy will go in that little hole. And it's livened that right up. It looked really boring before, didn't it? It looks a bit more better now, barn style. Right, so next day, that's all good. A little bit there that it's not completely got, but I can just touch that bit up. But other than that, it's gonna, the base is only gonna screw into this bit anyway, so it hasn't got to be immaculate, just as long as it's level. Which it is, it's nice and flat, it looks tidy, and yeah, let's pull these off. Yeah, look, that is completely gone. A little bit of epoxy there, a little bit of overspill, but that will just sand off. That one's all good. A little bit of sanding required, and that one is perfect as well. All right, so let's do the get the top sorted out. Let's try and put some character in it. Just mixed up 420 mils of clear epoxy. That should be enough just to flood the top for first coat. Don't want to go too mad because you just end up with loads of bubbles. Whatever happens, you will get bubbles on this anyway, so don't fret.
I repeat the same routine.
got it up to 600 grit. There's no point me sanding it all the way from 80 grit. Well, I actually started on 120 this time. So I went from 120 upwards, 180, 243, 24, and now I'm at 600. I've got an 8, a 1,000 and a 2,000 left. I've still got to do around the sides, but I don't know if I'm going to do the around the side here yet. I'll see how it looks. But yeah, so what I'm going to do, I'm going to start filming from there, give you a few just how I've been doing it. And then, that's 2,000 grit. Should polish up okay. I've had it clear, don't get me wrong, but it's only a small one. It's and there is bubbles in it, so I'm expecting it not to be 100% perfect, but still a nice little table. Put a little bar top table bases on it. All right, let's go. Smudge it on, get it in there. Polish, I've got to show you that. That was that pad, 3M. There you go, people, one island ocean bar table.